So here we'll look at different types of variables, and in particular we'll break these down into four different categories. So we'll start with qualitative. So qualitative variables are also known as categorical variables. And this should give you some idea of what's going to happen here. In particular, these variables have distinct categories. According to some kind of characteristic or attribute. So, according to some characteristic. So, this is why it's called a categorical variable. It's things that we can put into different categories. Some examples would be religion or gender. And there are lots of other examples. But basically, these are anything that we can categorize. Next, we have qualitative. And qualitative variables are also known as numerical variables. So this should also give you some idea of what's going to happen here, probably numbers. And basically, this is anything that can be either counted or measured. So any kind of numbers that can be counted or measured. So for example, height is something that we measure, or we can look at the number of people in a room. And this would be something that we count instead. So these are any kind of numerical values, any kind of numbers. Now we can further break down these different types of variables, these numerical variables, into two categories. The first are called discrete. So discrete variables are anything that can be counted. Anything that we actually count. So, for example, the number of people in a room. Another example, if I looked at the number of cars in a parking lot. These are all examples of discrete variables, things that we can count. In addition, money is a discrete variable. It's something that we can count as well. The last one is continuous variables. These are the other type of quantitative or numerical variable. And these are things that we measure. So some examples would be height or weight. In particular, with continuous variables, the main thing is, do fractions or decimals make sense? So with discrete variables, when we talked about the number of people in a room, a fraction or a decimal of a person in a room wouldn't make sense. However, if we're talking about height, saying someone is 5 feet 5.5 inches does make sense. The only exception to this rule would be the money, in which case decimals make sense. However, it is still discrete because we do count it.